Good morning, friends. Now, when you have put a step forward for opening a bakery, then the first thing that comes into your mind is location. How I should go about choosing a location which suits my requirement, and that location should be such that it gives profit to my organization. So today I will discuss with you how to choose the location for your bakery. I will tell you all the ins and outs of choosing the location, which plays a vital role in making your business a profitable business. My dear friends, before starting a bakery unit, it is necessary to decide the location, where it is to be established, because proper selection of site would lead the business to its maximum potential. And on the opposite, if we choose a wrong selection, it will lead to less volume of business or loss to the business. Hence, while selecting site, it is necessary to survey the market for bakery products of the proposed area in order to decide the size and scope of the project. For small scale bakeries, the following points should be kept in mind while finalizing the location of the bakery. The first thing that comes into mind is availability of raw materials easily. My dear friends, you should choose such a place where the raw materials used in bakery, like flour, sugar, fat, yeast, etc., is easily available in the market. Because being a small scale entrepreneur, you cannot invest large amount in piling up the stocks of your bakery. And due to non-availability of raw materials in the market, your production can stop. Moreover, if suddenly a big order is placed, the products can be made easily after purchasing the raw materials from the nearby market. In such circumstances, if raw material is not easily available, one had to lose the order and ultimately decrease the profit. Moreover, if the market is close to the bakery, it will mean less distance to purchase the things for bakery, and hence less transportation cost, which help you to decrease the production cost and ultimately your profit. So you should look out for a market which is where you can easily get your raw materials and is closer to your bakery. The second point that you need to keep in mind is market or the product. You should look out for the market of your product. You should choose a place where the mobility of the people is more, like railway station, bus stand, hospitals, schools, hostels, etc., or where there is high density of population, etc. This will help you to target audience which is large in number, and hence will help you increase your business. There will be different types of people whom you can target. The third thing which needs to be kept in mind is availability of basic necessities for opening the bakery. There are certain basic requirements for opening a bakery, like easy potable water. Water is one of the most important commodity of your bakery. So be careful while selecting the location that water is easily available to you, as maximum number of products require water for preparation. And water is also needed to keep the equipments, working tables, hands, and premises of the bakery to be clean. If the water of the area is not good, you need to take extra precaution for purifying the water and increasing the cost of the product. Hence, you should look out for an area where easily potable water is available. The second consideration is electric power. It is required to help the electric operated ovens, machines, lights, etc. to work properly. If there is problem of electricity, then you will not be able to produce the product in large quantities, as the operation will get hampered in the night. If there is, for example, if there is a cut of electricity and the electricity is not there for at least 12 hours in an area, so you will have production time of only 12 hours to work with, which is not desirable. Hence, you should look that the area, you should look out for the area where there is uninterrupted power supply for the full day. The next point is transportation facility. Transportation facility should be available for handling ingredients, products, as well as commuting facility for the workers, employees. If you have good transportation facility to your bakery, then you will be easily able to supply your product to far off places. But if the transportation facility is not good, you will not be able to give out the orders in time. Next thing to be kept in mind is communication facilities. Today we are going towards the global communication. Now we have number of communication facilities available to us, like post, telephone, more over internet. Internet had drastically changed the way of working a bakery should be. Now a number of the orders are placed through the internet and they can be purchased online. So you should look out for the area where all these facilities like internet, your postage system, postal system, like telephone, internet or fax facilities are available. Last but not the least, waste disposable facility. You should look out for simple that in the area you should have a good sewerage system along with waste water disposable system. And there should be somebody who should look after your garbage, that it is to be properly dispensed off. So these are the little basic necessities which you need to look after, that is easy portable water, electricity, transportation facility, your communication facilities, and waste disposal system. The next one more thing which needs to be kept in mind is local labor force. Local labor force, how does it help you in cutting down the cost? If we hire the labor from abroad, we have to pay him a larger salary and have to look after his own accommodation, fooding, lodging, boarding, and so the salary will be much higher as compared to the local available market, which is cheap. It will help us to reduce our production cost. Moreover, in case of sudden absence or big order, that they may be easily replaced by hiring the local casual labor. Otherwise, it will be difficult to maintain the production schedule. Next, one more important point to be kept in mind is socio-economic condition of the people. What is the purchasing power of the people in that area? Will they be able to buy our product, which is high on the cost, or will they be able to produce in bulk if we keep the price of our product lower? We should collect the information on economic conditions, purchasing capacity, choice of food, food habits of the people, choice and habit of bakery products, consumption, etc., of the people nearby the proposed place of bakery unit, so that you may have the exact idea regarding the types of products to be prepared. If the technical information on the preparation of such products is not known, that can be obtained, learned from suitable sources like catering institutes, etc. Another important point, my dear friends, which you need to keep in mind while choosing a location is study of competitors. You should know who your competitors in the area are. Collect the information regarding volume of their sales, their production capacity, type and quality of products being produced by them, and study them carefully to know your weaknesses and strengths than your competitor, so that you can easily estimate what products you had to manufacture and of what quality and at what price to remain in the competition. So the study of competitors is must. Another point which goes a long way in deciding about the location of the bakery is benefits provided by the government for small scale industries. In many areas, like in Himachal Pradesh, in Baddi district, government promotes the establishment of the industry by providing benefits like loan subsidy, free tax, cheaper electricity, etc. One can think about these benefits and you can establish unit in such areas to avail those subsidies and cut your production cost. My dear friends, besides all these points, we one more thing in our mind, that is future expansion plans. Nothing is possible without considering our plans. We should proceed and look out for the future plans which we have kept in our mind, and for that you should choose location that there is enough space for future expansion. If the premises is small and all the space is used and there is no room for necessary extension, consequences on increased business will show a complete lack of ambition and foresight. Last point, but not the least, to be kept in mind that your bakery should be easily visible to the customer, that your location of the bakery, the people can come to your bakery, and it should be easily visible so that the finished building becomes a landmark, so that people do come to know of your brand name, and it is the cheapest source of publicity for your customer. A good bakery, but hidden between giant factories, will lose the potential for easy publicity. I thank you and hope understood the points which needs to be kept in mind while choosing the location. Though you cannot get 100% implementation of these points, but if we are able to achieve 70% of these, then also we see that we can get good returns for our bakeries. Thank you. Good morning. Today we will discuss about how to lay out a bakery plan. Now, when you are considered to open out a bakery and do it too small in nature, then what are the points which needs to be kept in mind while opening a small bakery? There are many bakeries in the world, my friends, but none of the bakeries will look the same. Each bakery will have its own layout and have different designs. If the placing of equipment and apparatus in the premises is done in a way that the production can take place in a sequential way, it is called an efficient plant layout. I will again give you the definition. If the placing of equipment and apparatus in the premises is done in a way that the production can take place in a sequential way, it is called an efficient plant layout. Now, what is sequential way? Sequential way is, in the ordinary terms, we say the process should start from a sequence, right from the purchasing of raw materials to the manufacturing of end product. That is a sequential order. We will discuss it later in this chapter. Now, what are the things required on which we can lay out our premises for the bakery? The very first thing, the size of the company, whether you are going for a big size company, small size bakery. So that is the one of the key points for laying out the premises. The second is the size of the premises available to you. Third, the type of the company which you are catering to, whether you are going for a single product company or a multiple product company. If you are only going to manufacture a single brand, so the layout will be different. But if you are going to manufacture multiple products like biscuits, patties, pastries, cakes, and bread, then the layout will be different. And then another point, key point to be kept in mind is financial aspects. How much finance do you have to invest in laying out a bakery? Now, a large scale company has other requirements than a small scale company. In large scale companies, we talk about plants. The processing from raw materials to the final product is completely mechanized. Nothing goes through the hand of a person. It is all through with the help of machine. The premises are big, very long, to accommodate the plants efficiently. A small scale company often has the production and shop in one building. In this situation, The layout for the bakery is completely different. The production is not fully mechanized. Usually, the variety of products is big, and we often see the production of bread and confectionery in one department. It is obvious that the more the space available, the easier a proper layout can be designed. Existing urban bakeries hardly have enough space. The layout and extension of these type of bakeries is very, very hard. Machines, apparatus, and workbenches are put so close together that there is hardly any space left for production. A company manufacturing only bread will have a different layout from the bakeries which only produce confectionery items or multiple products. This thing we need to keep in mind. If we are only manufacturing the bread, then the layout will be entirely different than the company which is producing confectionery items along with the bread, or they are producing multiple products including bakery and confectionery. If the bakery is only producing for its own shop, there will be a lot of production time available. But if the bakery is producing for other shops as well, it requires a different layout, more storage space, because the products have to be made available for transportation early in the morning. In some bakeries, a 24-hour production is necessary because of economic reasons, and hence a different layout. So we come to the conclusion that the layout of the bakery differs according to the situations. The financial possibilities are also an important factor. To avoid unnecessary risk, it is advisable to start with the minimum amount of machines required. It always takes some time to you to penetrate the market. With a low investment and a fully mechanized bakery, money will be with a low investment and fully mechanized bakery. You cannot look out for a fully mechanized bakery with low investment. But if you invest a large amount of money on your equipments, then there are chances that you will lose the money if full capacity is not utilized. For an efficient layout of bakeries, the following things should be kept in mind. First, the output of the bakery. What is the output of the bakery? As I have already told you, that for producing the bread, we will need a different type of bakery. For producing multiple products, we need a different type of layout. Second, the transportation of raw materials and final products. If we are going to transport raw material and final products to other shops, then the layout will be different. The position and size of storage room for bread and for confectionery products. The position and size of the dispatch room, from where the product is going to be sold to the market. The size of the shop. The possibility of producing bread and confectionery products in separate areas. The amounts of workers necessary. The position and size of changing rooms, toilets, showers, and mess room. The offices, if necessary. While designing a layout, we need to consider all these upper points to be able to lay out a very efficient bakery. Now, what are the other things which needs to be kept in mind are the entrance or the company should be in a way that the delivering of raw materials, the delivering of fuel, the packing of transport material, dispatching of the finished product should not take place in public areas. The public should not be able to see what you are receiving or what you are dispatching. For an efficient conduct of business, it is necessary that the different stores and working areas like raw material stores, bakery production areas, dispatch rooms, offices are situated in such a way that correct routing can be obtained. The size of the premises should be in a way that a small increase of the sales is possible within the existing buildings. the position of the machines, operators, tools, raw materials, finished products, etc., and entrance of other rooms should be in a way that an efficient production process is possible. What are the different areas of bakery plant that should need to be kept in mind? Now we have defined bakery layout into four major areas, that is raw material receiving and storage area 1, second is bakery room where the bakery products are being manufactured, third is confectionery room where the confectionery products are being manufactured, fourth, finished product storage room where the finished product will be stored, fifth is your office, which is optional. Now we will discuss about these four sections in detail. Now first is raw material storage area. Raw material storage area is the, in general, raw materials are supposed to be stored in a dry and cool place. The storage rooms should have a good ventilation system. Insulation is sometimes necessary because raw materials like flour, fat, yeast, and dried fruits require a low temperature, that is 15 degrees centigrade or below. It is advisable to install racks and stands to store the raw materials separately and conveniently. A trolley to transfer the raw material is also required. Raw materials should be kept close to the production area. The construction of floor should be in a way that it can carry about 1000 kg per square meter. A conveniently arranged storage room will not only save your time, but certain ingredients, when required, will be easy to locate, and it will be easy for you to stock take the ingredients. Another important point which needs to be considered while designing the storage area is the pest control. The pest control in a spacious room can take place more efficiently. It will result in improved hygienic conditions. It is often seen that the scaling of raw materials take place in the storerooms and thereafter are issued to the production area or bakery. So for the proper scaling, you should have proper scaling equipment so that the raw material which is being issued to the production areas is of right quantity. Now, the second point which we will discuss is bakery and confectionery rooms. Now, my dear friends, the bread bakery as well as the confectionery bakery room requires their own temperature and humidity because the products produced are of different character. Due to different requirements, it is advisable to have two different production areas, one for the bakery and the other for the confectionery. Confectionery products are usually sweet in nature and, like working of chocolates, do require a particular type of temperature. So we need to keep two different areas, whereas for bread, for the yeast to get activated, we need a hot and humid temperature. So for both of these, we need to have two different rooms, one for the bakery and one for the confectionery room. But if we are having a very less investment, then we are left with no other alternative but to make bakery and confectionery room as one room. The bakery is a place where the production basically takes place. A very poor layout will affect the cost price of the products considerably. The position of the machines and operators should be in a way that no handling or step is done or overstepping is done if not necessary. The routes start at the raw material store to the dough production area. Through processing equipment and fermentation rooms, the dough reaches the oven, followed by the bread store and dispatch area to the shops. This production line should be very short as possible, with no or very little crossings. It will not always be possible to have no crossings at all. Several circumstances can cause interference, like the way the bakery is built, the variety of products being manufactured, the amount of products produced out of one group, the position of the already existing oven, the position of the different areas. In a small bakery producing bread as well as confectionery products in one room cause more problems than in bakeries with separate bakeries or a bigger room for bakery and confectionery rooms. All the different products are always going to one place, that is oven. So the more different products, the more are the problems of crisscrossing each other. To get a cross-free product line, it can often be seen that the layout of bakery is a compromise. If possible, confectionery products and bread products should be produced in separate areas because of the different requirements, that is temperature, humidity, equipment, etc., that is of major concern. Those areas which require a lower temperature, example offices and stores, should be planned in the cooler part of the building. Now we will talk of the production line in the bakery. The production has to be take place in an area which can be prepared in a way that the doughs do not cool down and skin during processing. A provision for heat and humidity is advisable for the bakery unit. The production line in the bakery unit consists of the following items: storage of flour, you need to store flour for making of bread, transport of flour to kneading area, you need to transport flour from the store to your production area, dough kneaders in which you need to knead your dough, and water supply for manufacturing. Then we have dough divider. After dough, dividing the dough into different scales for making of bread, then we need an intermediate proofer. After proofing, we need different molders to mold the bread. Then we have second proofing, that is known as final proofing. For that we need final proofers, oven for the baking and transport and cooling of the bread. Then we have slicers for slicing of the bread and wrapping machines for wrapping of the product. At the end, we will require transport to produce the product to the store from where it has to be outsourced to our own shop or to the customers. In general, we can say the same layout is used for different size of bakeries. The higher the capacity, the more stages are mechanized. Small bakery plants like you are thinking of can consist of a dough kneading machine, a proofer, an oven, a bread slicing machine, and packing machine. With this, you can open out a bread bakery unit for yourself with a very less cost for your bakery setup. Now we will discuss about the confectionery room, the third area, which is confectionery room. The confectionery room also requires a separate room. Why? Because of temperature and humidity, already explained to you. The confectionery bakery requires cooler working areas and almost a low humidity. For chocolate processing, a low temperature and humidity are really necessary. So that is why we should have a different confectionery room. A proper layout in the confectionery bakery is also very necessary. Most of the time, the manufacturing of the products requires a lot of manual work, and a clear production line cannot be seen. The variety of products also contributes to this. We still have to look for the shortest way between the raw materials, half products, and the finished products. Crossings have to be avoided as much as possible. Apparatus or equipments, as we call, often used in confectionery are planetary mixers for mixing of the doughs, pastry sheeters for rolling out the dough in case of patties, biscuits, etc., biscuit cutters, dough kneaders, tart liners, refrigerators, Another important point to be kept in mind is refrigerators. For storing the confectionery product, we need to have very good refrigeration system. And last, ovens. Due to the type of product, this bakery requires a layout emphasizing on hygiene. It means that the room is easy to clean, the walls and floors are kept in a good condition, etc. Now, we will talk about the finished product store. What are the points to be kept in mind while choosing a store for our finished product? An efficiently arranged product store has to meet the following requirements. First, the finished products have to be stored fast, neatly, and in a cool place. The products have to be stored directly on the right spot to avoid damages and reduce labor cost. The arrangement should be neat in relation to stock taking. The loading of transport means has to take place fast and efficiently. Easy and fast cleaning is required. The store should be properly ventilated. The store should be close to the production room, and it should meet all the legal requirements of that area. For bread storage, several possibilities are available, like racks against the wall, be freestanding racks. The second is bread trolleys, bread cupboards, bread crates, movable trolleys. The best system for most of the bakeries is to use movable bread trolleys or racks. Where the bread is put for cooling and put back again after slicing or wrapping. The other possibility is to put them in crates immediately after wrapping. This system requires a lot of crates but reduces the amount of labor for packing the wrapped loaves into the racks and from the racks into the crates. For hot bread shops, a system can be used whereby movable racks are loaded in the store, completely filled and transferred to the shop. For confectionery products, a special often cooler store is used. It is obvious that special attention should be placed to the security. All incoming and outgoing products should be registered properly. Therefore, it is advisable that separate workers are employed for production, storage, and transportation. Now we will discuss about the office. It is optional. You can always have a small office for planning out your production strategies, for planning out your marketing strategies, or else you can operate from the area where you are producing the products. The offices should be situated in a way that there is almost a direct contact between the different departments like store, dispatch area, shop, etc. The following activities take place in the offices normally, that is production planning, raw material administration, stock controlling, debtor accounting. In general, all matters involved in purchase, production and sales are discussed in offices. So it is optional for you either to have a small office where you can plan out these things in a good working environment. Now, we have discussed all the points which needs to be kept in mind while laying out a bakery. Now, there are certain recommendations which a person must follow while planning a layout for the bakery. The first recommendation is that you should try to have floors that they are sloping the water to the pits. It should have a slope so that the water is easily drained away from the kitchen. It prevents water from remaining on the floor after cleaning. The floor should be kept clean because raw materials like flour and sugar can easily damage the floor. The capacity for water and electricity should be sufficient, keeping in mind that a fair overcapacity is often cheaper then additions afterwards. We should have a clear understanding that water and electricity should be easily available, because if we do not have electricity in our area and we have to use genset for manufacturing the product, it will be on the higher production cost. And if we do not have potable water, so we have to treat the water, which will again lead to increase in the production cost. Another point to be kept in mind is water supply should be sufficient and available at several places. You should have hot and cold water for the bakery production areas as well as for the cleaning. The design should be such that the equipment remain unhidden. Unhidden means that the equipment should not be behind the pillar where it is not easy to operate the equipment. And for the same reasons, pillars should be avoided. Now, a sufficient distance must be kept between each process, equipment and machinery to provide enough space for the movement of man and materials, and sometimes the machinery as and when required. If there is not sufficient space, then it will not be easy for the people to operate. So we need to keep sufficient distance between the equipment as well as for the working benches. The bakery oven should be located at one corner of the plant rather than in middle area. The area near the oven should be well ventilated, and installation of the exhaust fan is preferred. Raw material store and finished goods store should be situated in such a way that these could be kept locked without any interference in normal production areas. The doors should be big enough to carry out the machinery, equipment, etc. For the benefit of the workers, first aid facilities, washing facilities, and sanitary facilities should be available. Planning for firefighting facilities is also very essential. For that, a certificate from local authority should be obtained. These are the points with the help of which you can plan out your small bakery or a medium-sized bakery or even a large bakery. Now we will further discuss these things in detail in the practical session, which we will be taking later on. Thank you.